Good morning, children. Today's class is for 8th standard and the subject is biology. Lesson is the same, children. It is crop production and management. Today's our topic is basic practices of crop production. So, children, the previous class we have started learning about crop, how crop is producing, what are the two types of crops, which are the systems it is required for making all these crops. We started already. So, continuation of that, we will do the next point, that is cultivation of crops only and agricultural practices. Okay, here we know that it is always this crops and management, this see know that it is mainly related with farmers only. Here one more point you should remember, children. Father of green revolution. See, greenery, it is green is related with agriculture, you know that. So the father of green revolution, that is Dr. M. S. Swaminathan, he is from Tamil Nadu only. He is considered as the father of green revolution. That means he has done a lot of work in agriculture and all. That is why he has given that title, father of green revolution. So you should remember this point. Who is the father of green revolution? You tell me, children. Yeah, it's correct. It is Dr. M.S. Swaminathan. Okay. So we will come back to the topic. Here, cultivation of crops. We know that, children, it requires different activities. For cultivating crops, we need different activities. First, we know that land is required. Alright. And before that, we will see that some agricultural tools, some tools, equipments are required for this agricultural practices. Actually, that is meant for only agricultural practices. We are commonly not using at home. See, for example, sickle. That is one agricultural tool. Another one is khurpi. Another one is hoe, then plough is there, tractor is there, cultivator is there, leveler is there. These all are meant for, these all utensils or tools are meant for agricultural practices. We know that farmers generally use all these tools like sickle, khurpi, hoe, plough, tractor, cultivator, leveler. These all are for different uses are there. Okay, they are having different uses, different occasions they will use it. So you should know on this point, agriculture, what are few, at least 2-3 agricultural tools you should know it. Then we know that it requires different steps for making, for cultivation or for cropping. Different steps are required. Immediately we can't go and crop the product plants. Okay, so that is step by step they have to do it. So that different activities is called the agricultural practices. We'll see that what are the different activities the farmer supposed to do, and those activities together it is called the agricultural practices. What are the work supposed to be done in the land? That is called agricultural practices. Suppose we are going to grow paddy or rice, we need to do some steps. Immediately we can't just go and get the paddy from the field. So for that we have to do some work step by steps. So what these farmers are doing, for first that you know that first we already know that land is required. Some land is required for cropping or agriculture. So first one is preparation of soil. That land should be prepared for fit for the crop or growing of plants. That is called preparation of soil. The soil should be prepared. That is the first step. So agricultural practices, different steps are there. First one is that preparation of soil. Soil should be fit for the crop. Simply we can't go and just put some seeds in the plot. Okay, so before that the soil should be prepared. It should be ready for receiving the seeds. So that is the first step, preparation of soil. And after that, see, now the soil is prepared. The second one is, what is the second one? What we should do? We have to put the seeds. That putting seeds, that is called sowing. So, S-O-W-I-N-G, sowing. S-O-W-I-N-G, sowing. That is, putting seeds in the land is called sowing. That is the second steps. Then after that, what we supposed to do after putting seeds? We should give fertilizers or manures. Then it's like food. We also eat food for getting energy and all like that. Plants also, seeds also need their food. So it is already there in the soil some, but still we have to add. Okay, that is and in manures and fertilizers, that is the third steps. So here agricultural practices, you tell me what is the first one, first activity, first step, that is preparation of the soil, that is the first step. So after that what we'll do, sowing. Sowing is the putting seeds, that is called sowing. Next one is adding manures and fertilizers, adding manures and fertilizers. Then next one, after that what we should do, we know that if plants are there at home, say flowering plants are all there at home, and what we will do, we will give water to the plants, that is called the irrigation. So irrigation should be there. Then after that, the next one is protecting from weeds, that is the next steps, protecting from weeds. After that, the next one is harvesting, the last one is storage. So these all are the different steps which involved in the crop production, or it is called agricultural practices. Involved in the crop production, first one is preparation of soil. So after that, sowing only, sowing is nothing but putting seeds. Next one is adding manures and fertilizers. Then after that, irrigation. Next one is protecting from weeds. Next one is harvesting. Next one is storage. These all are the different practices. It should be done step by steps. Okay. Then the last one here, harvesting. When the crop is matured, it should be removed from the land. That is called the harvesting. Then after that, what will happen? That grains or that product should be stored properly for the further use. That is called storage. So these all are the different agricultural practices. Tell me once again, children. The first one is what? Yeah, correct. It is preparation of soil. Preparation of soil. Next one is sowing. Next one is adding manure and fertilizers. Next one is irrigation. Next point is protecting from weeds. Next one is harvesting. Next one is storage. And this all we will study one by one. Okay, after this we will study what is the preparation, what are the steps should be taken for preparation of soil, how it is going to be done, what are the tools we will use for the preparation of soil. Then after that we will see that what, how seeds will be put, which seed should be selected for growing. We can't just select any seeds, okay. Seeds should be in good quality, then only the plant will be in good, it will give good yield. Then adding manures and fertilizers, that also we know that generally organic manures should be more recommended, because we know that the chemical fertilizers and all, it will give some health issues and all. So generally organic manures will be more recommended. Then after that, irrigation. Irrigation is watering plants. That also different methods are there for putting water. Then protecting from weeds. You know, children, what is the meaning of weeds? Weeds. What is the meaning of this weeds? W-E-E-D-S. Weeds are the unwanted plants which will be growing along with the crop. We know that along with the crop there will be grass and some other unwanted plants will grow. That should be removed. Otherwise what will happen, you know, children? The fertilizers and manures will be taken by these weeds. Actually, it is not required at all. It is unwanted only. It is having no use for us. So it should be actually removed. Then in case it is not removed, what will happen? These weeds will be taken on this manures and fertilizers or nutrients from the soil. Then the crop will be getting less nutrients only. So for that purpose, these weeds should be removed in timely. Okay. After that, after some time, see by after 2, 3 or 4 months, the plant is ready for harvesting. It is growing, mature and should be removed from the land. That is called harvesting. And the next one is after harvesting, that grains or whatever vegetables or fruits, it should be separated and it should be stored properly. That is called storage. So these all are the agricultural practices. Agricultural practices. These are the different steps. Then we'll go back again and some agricultural tools. You learned already agricultural tools are sickle, tuffy, hoe, plow and all. These all are having different work or functions. Then cultivation of crops requires different activities, that we learned it. And who is the father of green revolution? Dr. M. S. Swaminathan is known as father of green revolution. Okay children, we will conclude this part now. We will go next topic in next class. Thank you, children.